Hey guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Move and it's time for another movie review. And this time I'll be reviewing a movie with my friend of mine, Emery. So how are you doing, pal?
Pretty good, how you been?
I'm doing good. Okay, can you say the name of the movie that we're reviewing today?
It's called Black Klansman and it's directed by Spike Lee.
So, anyway, since you are the guest, you start.
Okay, well, I really...
Just remember that this is a spoiler-free review. No spoilers.
Oh, okay. Well, I really enjoyed this movie, and I liked that it accurately portrayed a true story, and I really like detective kind of movies, so I thought it really worked.
Yeah.
It's the best thing Spike Lee's done in a long time.
So anyway, I'm gonna start by talking about the characters. Three of them, like I usually do. I'm gonna start by talking about Ron Stallworth, played by John David Washington. Now, he is a cop, but he seems more like a fucking spy to me.
Well, he's an undercover cop.
Oh, I see. I think he's a very good character, and he is very damn good at his job. So, what do you think of him?
I think he was very well portrayed in the movie. I like that Spike Lee is very left-wing and Black Lives Matter and whatnot, but he didn't try to make the movie say that all cops were bad. He didn't try to make it like a fuck the cops kind of story. He told the story about a guy who was a good cop. He wasn't a bad person, you know?
Yeah, alright. The next character that I'm gonna talk about is Flip Zimmerman, played by Adam Driver. Now, the thing about this guy is the fact that he pretends to hate Black people in order to know what a very racist group is up to. He must have felt very dirty pretending that.
Well, I mean, he was Jewish himself, and he pretended to hate Jews. And, I don't know, I think that's the best performance Adam Driver has given. I mean, I think he's better in this than he is in Star Wars, honestly.
Yeah. I found the scenes where he was trying to find out what that racist group was up to interesting. Or what is that group called again? Klan?
The Ku Klux Klan.
Oh, yeah, right. Alright, now I'm gonna talk about Chief Bridges, played by Robert John Burke. Now, he is a pretty fucking cool police chief. What do you think?
I like him. I liked him well enough. I think he was a good chief.
Yeah, now, Now, I'm not talking about the characters. There are only things I want to talk about. The next thing that I want to talk about is the fact that what I absolutely fucking love about this movie is just how anti-racist it is. Yeah, there are a lot of racist people in the movie, but this movie is definitely an anti-racism movie, and that's what I fucking love about it. Yeah, and it does very well. It does a very good job being anti-racism. What do you think?
I think it does. I'm very torn on the end with the footage that they showed of Charlottesville and Trump. That's not a spoiler, by the way. That's not spoiling anything. That's just something that they added on to the movie.
Yeah.
It was very weird. I think my favorite part of the movie was Topher Grace as David Duke. It was really weird to see him be such a hateful person in the movie.
Yeah.
Because he just seems like such a nice guy.
Yeah. Now, what movie period does this movie take place in?
The 1970s.
Oh, right. Alright, yeah. There was, yeah. Anyway, there's nothing else I can think about to say about the movie. So,
I got one thing. I didn't like that they had the girl and the relationship with the movie. I thought that was very added on. I don't think they really needed that to be the story, because I don't even think that actually took place in real life with the... I mean, I know the bombing and stuff... Oh, wait, that's... you kept that out. That's spoiler, too. But the girl, I read the book, and I don't remember her being a part of the story, or a major part of the story like she was in this. And I didn't like how she called him a house N-word, and it kind of felt like... I don't know. I don't like people saying that about Black people or Uncle Toms and stuff, because that's really just saying that they can't have their own opinion.
Yeah, well... There's one thing that you have to keep in mind about movies. Sometimes, when a movie is based on a true story, there's often things added to make the movie more interesting. You do know that, right?
Yeah, I know.
Well, anyway, I will get into my overall thoughts on this movie, but You go first, since you're the guest.
Again, I don't know everything about the true story, so I might have been wrong when I said the stuff about the girl and all that might have been in the real story. I don't know 100%, but I don't remember hearing about it. And if I were to give the movie a rating out of 10, I would say an 8.
But as for me, I absolutely fucking love the anti-racism message this movie has. And I appreciate movies like that because fuck racism. So, yeah. Overall, this is a great movie. And for that, I'm going to give it a rating 2 thumbs up. So I'm going to thank you for being in this review with me. It's been fun having you.
Yeah, no problem.
Well, guys, here's the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.